Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to share with you something you may not know about, copy and paste. Let's take a look. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. Patrick and I were just at the Power Platform Conference. We did a full workshop with Alex Powers. We had a bunch of people walking him through the day after Dashboard in a Day. And the thing that stood out to me was there was one moment where Alex was talking about Power Query because he loves Power Query, Power Query everything. He did something and everyone was like, whoa, wait, do that again. And what he did, enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do things here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So I'm inside of Power BI Desktop, and let me go into Power Query here. We'll look at my product table. I'm just gonna right click. I'm gonna say copy. I'm gonna go over to a new Power BI Desktop file. There's nothing in here. We'll open up transform data. So we're in untitled. There's no queries. Right click, paste. What the French toast? It just copied my query and everything's good because the source is valid in this context. What about parameters? So we're back in my AdventureWorks Power Query. Let's copy another table. This one's actually using my Excel file name parameter. Copy that, come into here, and I'm gonna do Control V instead of right click and paste because, you know, keyboard shortcuts. And bam, it brings in the parameters. So this is going to bring in any referenced item that that query is referencing. That's amazing, right? So we can easily copy items from one Power BI desktop file to another Power BI desktop file. Let's try some other things. Let's copy the same customer and let's go to Excel. And I'll say get data. We'll launch Power Query Editor. We'll say paste. Bam, that worked. So we got Power BI desktop. We got Excel Power Query. All right, let's keep going. So we'll come over to Power BI service and I'm gonna create a new data flow. We'll just add a new table here and I'm gonna go to other. Let's just do a blank query and I'm gonna go next just to get us into the actual Power Query Editor. Let's right click, we'll say paste and it wants you to use Control V. Okay, bam, there it is. Now, what you're gonna see here is that customer has this little bang on it. And that's because I need to set up the credential because it's a local file. And that makes sense. From the cloud service, it can't reach to the Excel file without some help, right? We need to go through a gateway and get all that set up, but it still pasted the query. If I go in into advanced editor, the query's still there. So I can easily transport one Power Query item to another area with ease, right? This is amazing. Copy and paste. Have you used it? Have you tried it? Did you know about this? Let me know in the comments below. I want to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.